All chips are in, quote unquote. Chip Kelly acts like he actually won a national championship. Yeah, that's what I don't like about Chip Kelly. His attitude, he's so arrogant. It's like he invented football, won a bunch of national championships, and graced the 49ers with his presence. Dude, you're just a loser. I don't know who you are. And now you're just ruining UCLA football for me, and I can't forgive you. Then he says, Mike, oh, keep going.
I want to talk about Chip Kelly. Yeah. Iggy, remember his introductory press conference, how he corrected you?
That's right. I said, Chip, do you still feel like the zone read can be the basis of an NFL run game? No, I said, do you still think the read option can be the basis of an NFL run game? And he said, what's the read option? What's the read option? It's the zone read. And he wouldn't answer the question. It's the zone read. What's the read option? And then a bunch of people were like, oh, Grant doesn't know the difference.
Yeah. Well, the point is, Iggy, he was supposed to be gracious. He was being introduced to everybody. And what he showed was he was a pedantic schmuck.
Yep.
He was a pedantic schmuck.
That is the scientific term.
And that's all. Iggy, you and I looked at each other when he did that. We were right in the auditorium and would say, this guy bears watching, right?
Yep. This guy's going to lose. He's going to fail. Watch. Yeah. Watch. Oh, you're already nitpicking the words of questions before training camp started. Oh, you're going to lose. You are going to lose this year. Watch. And you're not going to like the questions. They're not going to get easier, Chip. Oh, man. I miss that guy.
Chip
was such an easy target. The other thing I remember about him, this is a good detail. Make of it what you will. We covered him at Kezar. They had – all I'm going to say is his posture. I'm just going to describe it, and that's it. He did a – I'm sorry. Look at my dad. I'm going to be very gentle here. He did a group press conference, and he stood around, and my dad and I noticed that when Chip Kelly stands, his feet are touching. They touch. He stands like a penguin. Do you stand – I'm asking you at home. When you stand, do your feet touch? And isn't it kind of weird, people that do stand like that? I can't remember seeing anyone ever do that. And we both were like, look at that.
Know what happened, Iggy? Because I remember what happened. We were there. Yeah. And I said, look at his feet.
Look at his feet. I said, wow, that is weird.
I never saw a guy stand like this. Did it mean it was uptight? I mean, I didn't know, but it was something to notice. And okay, I have never mentioned that.
There was something very unathletic about it. And it was just kind of funny to see the head coach of the 49ers standing like, I don't know, Neville Longbottom from Harry Potter. I don't know if you remember who Neville Longbottom was.
Iggy, could you imagine Harbaugh standing like that?
Harbaugh would always want to have like an aggressive stance with his feet shoulder width apart and a little bit of a forward lean so you could feel the whole side. No, this guy was like, hi. Hey, everyone, how's it going? Like, oh man.
Problem here.
Oh man, you want him to be the first one off the bus striding towards the stadium. Uh-oh, Chip Kelly's in town. Watch out. Man, I don't understand how he won all those games in Oregon, but boy, that was a long time ago. Well, I think.
Was there another part to that question?
Yeah, there was another part to it. Hold on. It was, I think Mike McButt Clinchy was envisioning tackling you last night, Grant. That's a funny name for him. Do you remember Mike McClinchy's tackle last night? It was during, I think, the interception return. He tackled the hell out of someone. It was the best play he's had all year. He should definitely become a special teams player because he's way better at tackling than blocking. Maybe that's the thing. He should be on defense.